How do you see selling of supplements, selling of gear, and other things out of an affiliate's box with respect to the what you're trying to do and what you've been trying to do with professionalizing training? What's the downside there? I mean, why not sell supplements if you're an affiliate?
Look,
right, make some bucks.
I told our trainers in the gym that, you know, there was a point where we couldn't quite afford a janitor. It was brief, but I think you remember, and we had a duty roster, and people had the duty of cleaning the bathroom. And I maintain that it's we're cleaning the bathroom, but you do it on your own time after hours. Go in there and lock the door and clean it. I don't want the clients seeing the trainer cleaning the bathroom. You know, I want them to see a clean bathroom, but I don't want to see them cleaning it. There's something worse than cleaning the bathroom, though, as minor as that is. What you don't want to do is be selling shoes, for instance. Trying them on, let me stand up, wiggle around. You can wiggle your toes, let me see. No, I think I got a 10 and a half, I'll be right back. At the point that you're a Foot Locker employee, or acting like one, when I pull it from the shelf behind me and set it down, and also send you on your way with a rower and a pair of shoes, I'm now something else. I'm something very, very different. And it's not professional. I don't want my physician, my accountant, my attorney, my minister, my psychiatrist, or my trainer to have a pro shop.
Right.
Yeah, if you're in the business of professional services, then that's what you're in the business of.
Right.
To the extent you're selling crap, then you're no longer...
And I don't care how good that shit is. It could be the coolest fucking shoes in the world. I'm not selling them in my gym. Go to the
online store. Get them, just not here.
Right. It's apparent to us that anyone that really has something truly good for the affiliates doesn't need our leverage to implement it. You know, Rogue didn't need anything from us. We needed from them. And to be on the whiteboard, guys have asked for nothing. Those are friends. Those are just good dudes. If you have something to offer the affiliates, give it to them. Deliver it.
Right.
Don't get me to force them to buy it. And so when you come knocking on my door about something so wonderful for the affiliates, I tell them, you know, hey, they're every single one of them is listed on that right-hand column. Get busy, you know?
Right.
Call them up, each one of them. There is no financial interest or partner for this business that doesn't come from the perspective of the money on the table. We are not an investment-grade entity. And that we're taking a multi-generational family approach to this thing. Look, I've got thousands of affiliates in their late 20s, early 30s, thousands of them. And they want this thing to put their kids through college and maybe allow them to you know, live their dreams, right? Yep. To provide everything that anything work's ever gonna provide for them. They're counting on this. And that isn't the two-year, three-year, four-year, or five-year return of a patient investor. And it certainly isn't consistent with the this time next, you know, this quarter next year,
right,
kind of return of these people either. We're unsuitable for that. And our business model has works only through this modest, if not negligible, extraction of rents and us finding ways to leverage the power of the community and invest what little we get from this back into the community. What are examples of it? The games. I mean, the games are huge for the community. What do the games do? Well, you know, they're on television, and we can promote. And the games are ultimately an affiliate event, and it's also a significant cost for us. You know, for us and for Rogue, we're not making money off the games. We're spending money on the games, but it nets to affiliate recognition and success. And that's the charter, that's the commitment. And this will be here for my kids and for my grandkids. And never was the point to develop thousands of successful businesses only to take business back from them or distort the model. And it's not for sale. It's not mine, it's not ours to sell. I don't have that option. That's not on the table. I have family, I have friends. I have 4,000 affiliates, 40,000 trainers, maybe a million end users, and my integrity and sense of self to come home to at the end of the day. No, this isn't, this would never be an option. Never be an option. And the affiliates need to hold Lauren and I to that. You know, if we abandon the charter, if we find it okay to interfere with their businesses, they need to sue us.
For violating the original principles under which they...
I've promised them from the first affiliate to the last that we're only here to help, not to profit off you. We're only going to avail ourselves of opportunities that further their cause and business, only. And that doesn't look like putting shit on the shelves to sell. It doesn't.